I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
I was thinking more of day stars shine down on me. Let your love shine through me in the night.
Let us neither one do that to our wonderful partners. Let us instead welcome you to Nashville, Tennessee at the old Grand Ole Opry here at Opryland Hotel, where the winter wonderland is really, really gorgeous. Jan tried to tell me that these lights were spectacular, but until one has seen, does this mean we will have more lights at TBN?
I hope so. Isn't it beautiful? It just gets you in such a festive mood, and it reminds me, you know, we came by last night and they were off. No. And I thought, you know, it just makes the point so beautiful. Jesus said, let your light shine.
Yes.
So that all the world can see. And you can't shine in the daytime as much as you can shine at night.
Yes.
And let your light shine in the night.
Well, Danny, be sure and get a nice panoramic view. I mean, what'd they say, 1,000,001 lights in this beautiful Opryland Park. Some colored Christmas trees, some all white. The trees, even with the limbs bare, are gorgeous with these beautiful, beautiful lights. But guess what? Your old Holy Beamer has rolled to Nashville. Channel 50 is on the air. The Good News Live, praise the Lord, is going to be on tonight. And who are our special guests?
Pat Boone, Dottie Rambo, Billy Walker, Jack Green, Terry McMillan, Karen Wheaton, and just a lot of beautiful people from the American Theater at Opryland in Nashville, Tennessee.
Well, if tonight is anything like last night, the glory of the Lord came down, as Betty Jean sings it. So, why wait any longer? Let's leave this beautiful park. Oh, how gorgeous. It's raining. Your hair will be falling. Jan is leaving me. Shall we just say, live from Nashville, Tennessee, let's just praise the Lord.
From coast to coast and around the world, it's time to praise the Lord. Praise the Lord covers the major Christian events in America and across the world, from the heart of Europe. To the tips of Africa. From the centers of Asia, Central and South America, Shore Park, the world's largest prayer and praise gathering. Joining us from the American Music Theater in Nashville, Tennessee are well-known recording artist and actor, Pat Boone. Recording artist and songwriter, Dottie Rambo. Songwriter and recording artist, Jack Green. Country gospel singer and recording artist, Billy Walker. Recording artist and musical evangelist, Karen Wheaton. Studio musician and recording artist, Terry McMillan. Ready to take your calls, prayer partners around America.
The American Theater here in Nashville, Tennessee. The old Holy Beamer has rolled into town and the glory of the Lord is coming down. Yes? I'll tell you, Dan, come here. This is your part of the country. This is the South. And these are our tough partners. I mean, it is drizzling rain out there. Did the eyelashes stay on all right as we...
I told them what would really happen if it got wet. I wouldn't be able to see for days if these eyelashes fail.
True, how true. We will pray that the rain clears up. But would you welcome us all to your part, the South?
Isn't it a joy to be in the South? You know, I just looked back here and saw all these wonderful Southerners. Pat Boone was born right here in Nashville. And I know Karen's from Alabama. And all these... We've got an Alabamian over there. It's very exciting. But the South is just wonderful. Beautiful, sweet. Well, look. Just look. What else can I say?
Give yourselves a hand.
Gracious. Never in a hurry. And how many out here have ever tried grits?
They invented them. Yes, and red eye gravy and all of the good things that Jan has taught me to love and is a very good cook, I might add, and has brought her Southern culinary with us to California. Well, we're going to have a wonderful time tonight. You see all of these great folks that are going to bless you in song and in testimony. I think maybe before we get started, a little word from the Word, and then our pastor, Charles Cowan, is here from right here in Nashville, Tennessee, to give us a proper Nashville welcome and lead us in our prayer.
What happiness there is for you who are poor. This is Jesus' words. For the kingdom of God is yours. What happiness is theirs for you who are now hungry, for you're going to be satisfied. What happiness there is for you who weep, for the time will come when you shall laugh with joy. What happiness it is when others hate you and exclude you and insult you and smear your name because you are mine. When that happens, just rejoice and leap for joy. For you have a great reward awaiting you in heaven. And you'll be in good company, because the ancient prophets were treated that way too. But listen, all of you, Jesus says, love your enemies and do good to those that hate you, and pray for the happiness of those that curse you, and implore God's blessings on those who hurt you. Do good to them, lend to them. Then your reward from heaven will be very great, for you will be truly acting as sons of God. For he is kind to the unthankful and to those who are even very wicked. That's our Jesus. And that's in Luke 6. Isn't that beautiful?
Well, thank you, Jesus, for those good words. I haven't learned to practice all of them yet. At least I have quit praying for God to kill all of my enemies. And I am about 5 minutes ago, as you started reading that scripture. We're going to have church tonight, are we not? Let's tell our pastor, Charles Cowan, of Faith is the Victory Church, right here in Nashville, Tennessee. Welcome tonight, Pastor. Thank you for coming by again and giving us a little word of admonition.
Amen. Well, you know, last night was awesome.
Oh, Lord.
And I'll tell you, we had church here last night. And we're going to have church again tonight.
Yes, Lord.
I looked out into the crowd, and I see some of our folks here tonight from our church. Amen. And we're glad you're here. And we just want to take this opportunity before we pray, those of you that are watching by television, come on out and see us at Faith is a Victory Church. Amen. We'll feed you the Word, love you, help you, lift you up, and just believe God to meet every need that you have in your life. Now let's pray tonight for this service, and just pray that that anointing will just rest upon everyone that speaks, everyone that sings, and that God will deliver and set free tonight like He did last night. I believe thousands across this nation, across the world, were set free last night by the power of God. And we're believing for the same tonight. Let's pray. Father, we just thank you tonight for the privilege to assemble ourselves together. We thank you tonight for the anointing of the Holy Spirit of God. For the anointing of God destroys the yoke in every person's life. We believe tonight, Lord, that thousands of people will be delivered and set free as the anointing flows through the airwaves into their homes tonight to touch them at the point of their need. That every person tonight who sings and that every person who speaks will speak by unction of the Holy Spirit of God, and that you will be exalted, you will be glorified, you will be praised, and the kingdom of God will be enlarged. We believe it, Father, and we thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Everybody said,
amen.
Just before you're seated, we've got one young man I want you to say hello to that just blew into town today. Stu Roth, one of the original three Hebrew children, is here tonight. He and Jay Sekulow and my son Paul Jr., you know, worked together to get this little fledgling ministry called Sunlight Broadcasting.
That's correct.
How many years ago?
3 years ago, we started out with our first station, Channel 21 in Mobile. A year later, we added Channel 45 in Montgomery. Then it was Channel 40 in Memphis. And 2 months ago, we just celebrated our two-month anniversary for Channel 50 in Nashville, Tennessee.
Hello, Nashville. And it thrilled you, Stu, I know, as much as me. In fact, Mr. Director, get ready. How many in my little amen corner tonight are actually getting to tune in on Channel 50 right here? And wave real big at me tonight, will you? Help us get the word around now, will you? And bug your cable company to death until they put Channel 50 on cable. This new law that was passed last year by Congress, well, it's being challenged in the courts, but we believe it won't be too long till the cable systems will be required by a new law to place all of the broadcasting stations on the cable system. So, Stu, you'll have to keep us up to date on that. And now it's on to
Chattanooga. In fact, tomorrow, right here at Opryland, I will be signing off on the final documents so that Sunlight Broadcasting can build a full power station on Lookout Mountain, Tennessee, covering the entire Chattanooga area.
Tennessee, you're blessed. Will y'all pray for Stu and Jay Sekulow?
Want to add one thing. I want y'all to know that this is a miracle station, because last year in October of 1991, we went to get our building permit to start construction on Channel 50, and the local zoning board said, no way. Our zoning board and our zoning laws prohibit you from building a tower such as the one you want to build for your Christian TV station. 6 months later, six zoning hearings later, the Lord softened the hearts of those men on the zoning board.
Glory.
And we unanimously got approval to start building Channel 50. And I'll tell you, from a lawyer's standpoint, 6 months, Paul, to completely change zoning laws is an absolute miracle.
Indeed it is. Of course, it helped to have a couple of little feisty Hebrew lawyers bugging them too, okay? The Lord's raising up some wonderful young men. Oh, pray for Stu. Pray for Jay Sekulow. He's, I don't know where he is. He's out there giving the devil trouble somewhere tonight. You can be sure of that. You
well,
know?
He was in a three-day trial last week in New York, and that was pretty stressful. And we're still waiting to hear the finality about that matter. But keep him in your prayers, because every week he is somewhere else in a hostile environment fighting for the rights of Christians to proclaim the gospel in public places.
Okay. Thank you, Stu. Stick with us tonight. We'll have lots more good time. Let me just run down name, rank, and serial number. Hello, Pat Boone.
Yes, sir, Paul.
You going to help me sing and shout a little tonight?
I'm going to do my best with what I've got left.
Pat has earned his pay today, dear friends. What? Eight?
We did eight Gospel America shows today. I couldn't believe that your folks wanted to even, much less did it. But we had wonderful guests. I can't remember all of them. You wouldn't have time for me to name all the guests for eight shows. But certainly Bruce Carroll. We had Terry McMillan here, who really broke the place up. Rick Kua. We had Mylon Lefevre, of course, and Dottie Rambo, you're going to talk to here. Plus her daughter, her pride and joy, and Donnie, her son-in-law. And goodness, we had a group called Two Hearts, and we had a group you had on last night called Strong Tower.
Yeah.
And, Candy Hemphill and on and on and on. Great. And the great thing about it, I think, is, and a lot of these folks, some of these folks were with us almost all day, is that we had such a diversity of types of gospel music. And that's the idea of the Gospel America show, is to bring together country gospel, traditional gospel. We had black soul gospel. We had southern gospel. We had contemporary. We had some rock. I mean, every kind
rock.
Of, oh yeah, even some. There was some rocking going on here, but it was gospel rock. I mean, it was authentic. And so I think we were trying to cross-pollinate, let people who like one kind of gospel music realize that there's something very legitimate and also very enjoyable going on in other fields of music. Gospel music, you know, has contributed to all the other kinds of music. You hear songs, I said this sometime today, that that you hear songs that sound like gospel but aren't. They borrowed the music form, they borrowed the sounds, and they're anything but gospel. And then you also hear gospel songs that don't sound like gospel songs. I may do one in a minute. But we're borrowing from the other kinds of music that people like, and we just turn them into gospel songs, you know?
I myself am an old country and western man. Give me Jack Green and Billy Walker any day. And as I've said so often, I don't trust a man that doesn't like a little country music.
Yeah. I'll go along with that, yeah.
We'll be back and reminisce a little about the old home days. I got to meet your mom and dad here the last time we were in Nashville. And are they here again tonight?
No, they were. No, they're not tonight. They got tired of standing on this floor.
But
they're okay.
Good. We'll be back with Pat in just a little bit. Hey, let's tell our sweetheart, Dottie Rambo, we love her. She's back tonight by popular demand.
Hello, Judy. Hi, honey. How you doing?
I'm well.
Good. Well, I'm still floating around from last night.
Are we not?
We kind of have an afterglow.
Yes, yes.
I had some calls in from Dr. Fouts, from Tolson, some friends, and Nadine Brewster and her husband, Kelly, and they were saying they were just rolling in the floor speaking in tongues. And they're bad Pentecostal, you know.
I see.
Last night, I think, could have gotten into anybody's heart that loves Jesus. It just, I couldn't hardly go to sleep. I was so excited, and I just saw Jan and I saw Dino and everybody just Terry, all of us just floating together and just flowing together and praising God together. And I said, well, maybe the notes weren't great. Maybe we missed some words, Donnie and Reba. Maybe we didn't do it all right. But the Holy Spirit came in, cleaned it up, and it was great when he got through with it.
Yeah. And Dottie, the good news that Jan just told me is that the phone wires just burnt up last night with people phoning in to receive Jesus as Savior. I'll tell you, that's what thrilled me, and maybe before the night is over, we'll have a little update and can tell you how many new names have been written down in glory. That sounds like an old song, doesn't it? Did you bring the guitar again tonight?
I've learned not to leave that at home when I come to see you.
Hot dog. We'll get the old guitar out, and we'll sing some more with Dottie Rambo, okay? Will you all help us tonight? I know you will. Hello, Jack Green. How's my buddy?
Brother, good. Paul, it's nice to have you here in Nashville. After spending 30 years here, I feel like this is my home.
Yes.
And welcome back. Nice to have you here.
And will you sing my song again tonight?
You really want to hear it again?
I love it. He got that famous old country song, Born Again.
Yeah.
There goes my everything. I mean, the old boys used to sit around and cry in their beer over that one, you remember? But he got it saved, and it is now, he is my everything, right?
Amen. Same guy that wrote the first hit wrote the second version of it, Dallas Frazier.
Well, sing anything else you want, but will you sing that one for me?
Just one more time.
One more time. Let's tell Jack we're glad he's back again tonight, and also Billy Walker, how's my buddy?
Good to see you, Paul.
Do you know, you blessed me the other night and didn't even know it?
I did.
Do you know what? You were with us, what, several months ago over in, what, the Opryland?
At the Opryland, actually Opry House, when you were in South America, and then we were at the Royaca Theater.
The Royaca, okay, yeah. That's where we were. That program played in the middle of the night, a few weeks ago. And Lord have mercy, you had me bawling and squalling. That testimony of how the Lord turned this old country singer's life around and made a new creature out of him. And Lord only knows how many others were touched by that.
That's what the Lord does. You know, he just, if it takes tears, then it takes tears.
Amen.
If it takes joy, it takes joy. Whatever it takes, the Lord is there to meet our need. And he meets the needs of people that don't know him.
Hallelujah. Well, we'll have some more testimony and a lot more good singing tonight. I just feel at home with these guys. We've just adopted y'all as part of the TBN family. Is that all right?
Thank you.
All right. Hello, Karen Wheaton.
Hello.
Was the plane late?
Well, it's in wrong directions, but that's all right.
I'll tell a little secret. As the theme was rolling, this little sweetheart came dashing in with eyelashes flapping and everything, just like Jan. But you made it.
I made it. You know, I was thinking, I had church in my car all the way up here. So when I got to Nashville, I thought, well, the enemy's trying to steal my joy because he knows something wonderful is going to happen tonight. But he didn't get my joy. I'm here and I'm full. My cup's running over. And I have wonderful news. TBN is finally being aired in Decatur, Alabama.
Really?
Yes.
You don't remember the cable channel number, do you?
I believe it's 36. And right. Dwayne and I, you know, we had sown seed into TBN for our town to be able to receive it. And so we rejoice, and I can say hello to my church and my children, and it's just a blessing.
That's wonderful news. Let's welcome Decatur, Alabama, to the wonderful Trinity Broadcasting Network. Hello, Terry McMillan. Are you ready to tear that harmonica up again tonight?
I'm going
to
do it. I want to do it for Jesus.
I believe he means it. Could we do this train one more time?
Of course.
I tell you, I was clickety-clacking down the tracks last night. I tell you, how many did not hear Terry McMillan do this train last night? You did not hear it? Fasten your spiritual seatbelts, dear Lord in heaven. And we'll share a little more testimony. Anything else earth-shaking happened today? You were helping Pat Boone today, weren't you?
Yes, sir. He came in. I'd met him on the airplane about a month ago. And boom, here we are, you know, together. But I want to tell you, I called my grandmother, who sent many prayers up for me when I was out in sin. And she's so... I called her up when I really... 5 years ago when I turned my life over to the Lord, surrendered to the Lord, you know. And she said, son, you know, she talked like this, Terry Lee, I'm just so proud of you. You look so good and you sound good and you're doing just what I've been praying for you for about 25 years.
It's like, God bless the grannies. Lord, a lot of us are here tonight because of grandma and mother's prayers. Yes, sir. We're going to have church. Pastor, you forgot to tell me where Faith is the Victory Church is located here.
Okay, it's at 3344 Walton Lane. It's where Briley Parkway and Ellington Parkway intersects, and we're sitting up on the hill. We're about 2 miles from Opryland here.
All right, real close. All right. Well, y'all just turn to your neighbor, will you? Welcome them to the American Theater, Opryland, USA, Nashville, Tennessee. This is live. Praise the Lord coming to you. And we're going to have a wonderful time praising the Lord together. Pat Boone, are you ready, sir?
I think so.
Let's welcome one of country's legends, a hometown boy from right here in Nashville, Tennessee. He's going to get us underway with some good news tonight. Let's welcome Pat Boone.
Yes, sir.
All right.
I got good news. I got great good news. My soul is bound for glory. My future is secure. I got good news. I got great good news. I've got a friend in heaven, that's for sure. Hey, I got good news. I got great good news. God loved the world so much, he gave his only son. Ain't that good news? Ain't that great good news? If you put your faith in him, your battle's won. Not so long ago, all my world seemed dark. My heart was filled with bitterness and strife. Then I met the Lord, and he saved my soul and offered me his own eternal life. Hey, I got good news. I got great good news. God knows your every thought, but he loves you just the same. I got good news. Ain't that great good news? We have a Savior, Jesus is his name. Yes, sir. Now you can clap your hands. You can pat your feet, especially if they're white. Hey, I got good news.
I got great good news. God knows your every thought, but he loves you just the same. I got good news. Ain't that great good news? We have a Savior, Jesus is his name. Yes, sir. We have a Savior, Jesus is his name. We have a Savior, Jesus is his name. Good news.
And if I am correct, that is the theme song, is it not?
For yes,
the,
it is.
The new Pat Boone series on
yes,
Trinity Broadcasting.
I wrote the song, and I didn't want to use the word gospel, only because a lot of people don't know what gospel means.
True.
And I'm afraid that in the way of this world, good words sometimes get tainted, you know, by circumstances, things that, you know. So now you hear something that is referred to as gospel, it ought to spark us with good feelings. And with many of us, it does. But the people in the world that don't know even what gospel means, mm-hmm. and they think, oh, that's something not so hot, maybe, because of what the media does
yes.
to the legitimate good word. Yes. So gospel simply means good news.
Yes, yes.
And we do have the most wonderful good news ever in the history of the world.
Now, the first time Pat was doing his show about a few months ago, he was came out to sing the song he wrote, and he forgot the words.
Oh, yeah. I was so glad that Candy Hemphill did that today, a song she wrote, too. Yeah, just because you wrote it doesn't mean you're going to remember it.
I see.
Oh, yeah. And it was new. It was new, and I hadn't done it before. In fact, I'm never sure that I'm going to remember the words to any of my songs.
Well, just go on into tongues or something.
Yes, that I could do.
You can always do that.
Bing Crosby said, ba-ba-ba-ba-boo. I think it's because he forgot the words.
Very possible. Now, Nashville is home. You were literally born?
Yeah, no, I was not born here. I was born in Jacksonville, Florida.
Oh.
But I was only about a year and a half, almost 2 years old, when I hitchhiked up here to Nashville. Not really. I didn't hitchhike. Mom and Daddy brought me up here.
I grew up here.
This is, I've always thought of as home, although Jacksonville was my birthplace, and I love that, too.
Were you a good boy growing up in Nashville? Were you any...
I was a pretty... I got into all kinds of scrapes and mischief, and when I was here before, I told you, Mama, in fact, was on the stage and told you about how she used to spank me and what she spanked me with.
I remember, yes.
This sewing machine belt. Oh, man, yes. My legs go like this when I think about it.
Well, that's a good testimony. I myself am sort of persona non grata still in North Springfield, Missouri, but I just wondered if
You mean but they have let you back, have they?
Occasionally.
No wanted signs at the post office?
Nothing in the post office, thank the Lord. But would there be any old-timers here that remember Pat Boone as a kid growing up here? And
I'll bet you.
Some of your old compatriots are
here
tonight.
I'll bet you some. Yeah. Look here, that young kid saying he remembers me.
Oh,
no,
Lord.
He doesn't. But his grandfather might, or grandmother.
That ought to make you feel pretty good.
You know, it was interesting that you talked about the spanking before. When my dad first came up from Florida, the first place they bought a house was in Donelson, which is out by the Hermitage. Mm-hmm. And Daddy still was working with his uncle in the construction business, and it brought him to downtown Nashville. But we went to church in Donelson. So I was just a little kid. And so often, Mom and Dad always had us up on the front row or the second row of every service.
Yes.
We never missed a service, ever. So I was just 3, 4, 5 years old, and I really didn't understand what church was about. I knew that it was something serious, because Mom and Daddy always brought us. And I was not getting a whole lot out of the preacher, or what he was saying. I enjoyed some of the music. But there was the service was about a week long, it seemed to me.
I remember.
So now I would look around, and I'd have a friend or two somewhere in the congregation, and I would make faces, you know, or do something. And so Mama would tell me to turn around and straighten up and be still and be quiet. And I would just misbehave one time too many. All right, let's go. She'd take me, and we'd go up the aisle, right up to the back, out into the foyer or outside the church, and she would just spank the fire out of this little kid, you know. And you could hear, I don't know how the preacher kept preaching, because here he's preaching, and you're hearing this, and me crying out there.
Serious.
Oh, yeah. And now we come back down and sit in the front row again.
Oh,
and I was too young to be embarrassed. I just, that red glow was from being smacked and from crying. Well, it took till I was about five or so to get the message, because I thought, you know, it happened every service. I thought that was part of the service.
Jan has said that many times. Yes, yes, yeah. We all have had a...
It's a wonder I didn't become an atheist, you know. But then we moved to over to the South Nashville, first on Gale Lane, and then out to Lone Oak Road, where my folks still live, and went to Granny White Pike Church. And now the folks, many years after I'd left, come back. I went back to Donaldson, and the folks out there remembered me as that little boy got taken out and spanked every service.
Yes, yes.
But when I went back to the Granny White Church, the folks there remembered me as the boy that always sat on the first or second row and misbehaved.
Such
a model of behavior.
God give us more moms with
It took a little while, but no. I got the message.
When did you start singing in church, Pat?
In church? Well, always in church, but in leading, you mean, or taking a...
Well, that was going to be my exact next question. When did the little Pat Boone decide he wanted to be a singer and go into a singing career?
It was a gradual sort of a process, because Mama, though she's not a musician, not trained or anything, she did play the ukulele. She knew some chords, still does, play some chords on the ukulele. She taught them to my brother and me. And so, of course, we got to where we could sing two or three songs. And at family gatherings, when my brother was a year younger than I and is the song leader now at Madison Church, which is a great big church and a wonderful singer, and they have a TV program, too, called The Amazing Grace of Bible Class, I think it is. Well, Nick and I would sing together harmony. Mama taught us harmony. And so 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, you know, we did that in little family gatherings. And then there was a theater out in Belmead. There was the Belmead Theater. And on Saturdays, they had the Belmead Happiness Club. It was a Saturday afternoon cartoon, serial, you know, movie for kids. And mamas would bring kids over there and just fill that theater every Saturday afternoon for about 3 hours. And Ed Jordan, who was the manager, ran a talent show. And he would have kids audition down at the Elizabeth Bryant Combs dance studio in downtown Nashville. And if the lady who ran the dance studio wanted you to be on the show or thought you were okay, she would put you on that little talent show. So on Saturday afternoons, these kids would come on stage and sing a song or do a little tap dance that they learned at the...
Really?
I didn't do that, of course. You can see that. But
do you remember the first song that you sang?
The first?
As a young talent apprentice.
I think it was, "Oh, It's Only a Paper Moon."
Really?
"What's Sailing Over a Cardboard Sky, But It Wouldn't Be Make-Believe If You..." That doesn't even rhyme. That can't be it. "If You Believed And I..." No, maybe. I don't think that's it. Cardboard C, maybe. But anyway, I sang Paper... what did I just sing?
Paper Moon.
It was Only a Paper Moon.
Paper Moon, yeah, I guess so.
When did...
You tell I'm really getting groggy. I've had 8 shows today.
When did that graduate into the first even semi-professional appearance?
Well, here in Nashville, you know, it's called Music City, USA, and there were opportunities for young amateur talent to be heard and seen from time to time, talent shows and even some TV sometimes or radio. And so I volunteered to be on some of these programs because I'd had sort of a taste of getting up in front of people, and I liked singing, and they seemed to enjoy me at the time. So I would try it, and I was leading singing regularly in church, because after I was saved at 13, by the time I was 14 or 15, I was leading the congregational singing. And we don't have any instruments in the Church of Christ, so, you know, it's all congregational, and somebody has to stand up and try to beat time, usually, and lead, sing loud enough to carry the congregation along. So at 14 or 15, I was doing that. And then I had opportunity to be on some talent shows and won one eventually that sent me to New York, the Ted Mack Amateur Hour, and then the Arthur Godfrey Show, and then recording, and
the rest
took off from there.
Yeah, oh, that's great. How many have followed Pat Boone's career through the years? Back in the 50s?
Love Letters in the Sand. What were some of those big hits? Jan and I used to do our little dating listening to some of your
Friendly
songs.
Persuasion.
Friendly Persuasion, yes, yes.
And you mentioned April Love, I think.
April Love.
I'll Remember Tonight was another, and I almost lost my mind.
Yes, yes.
Tutti Frutti, Tutti of course, Frutti. Ain't That a Shame. Moody River,
yes.
Speedy Gonzales, things like that.
Yes, yes.
Lots of rock and roll.
Memories, memories, memories.
Yeah.
Well, the next song doesn't fit that category, but maybe a little splaining would be in order
would it not?
Yeah.
It's a song I wrote, and I did it today for the first time on the Gospel America program. And it does take a little explanation, perhaps, because it's one of those songs. It is a gospel song, but it doesn't sound like one. It really doesn't sound like one. I borrow it, really, the feeling of it from, remember a record from the 50s called Searching by the Coasters? I've been searching, boom, boom, boom. I've been searching every which way, yeah, yeah. You know that song?
Nope, never
heard it. No, never heard it. Well, you're too young, yeah. Well, I sort of borrowed that feeling because I was with Shirley in a little getaway in Hawaii once, and we were thinking about some of our brothers mainly, ministers, I say not natural, but spiritual brothers who have been in ministry situations, musically or some other way, and they didn't feel they needed to get involved in the body life, into fellowship. They felt that because they were doing something for God, and they are, and they were, that they could sort of stay apart, and they didn't need to be under the oversight of elders, didn't need to be in a local church or anything like that. After all, they were in church a lot, you know, and during the week or on weekends, and so they just never got into any real fellowship. And I thought to myself, I referred to them as the Lone Rangers, you know, the guy just rode around by themselves, as Lone Ranger Maverick type Christians. And one by one, they had tragic situations where they were caught in something, or they made a horrible mistake, or in one way or another, they were discredited. And yet, they really were, they loved God, and they really were valid ministers. And of course, then our tendency is to sort of write them off and forget about them. And maybe that's one of the reasons that word gospel has been tainted a little in the thinking of some. So I'd written this song called The Lone Ranger. And I also, I'm probably the first time ever to equate the Holy Spirit with Tonto. But
really?
You'd, yes.
This is different.
You'd have to, that silent partner who never said very much but was always there.
So is this for all the Lone Rangers?
This is for Lone Rangers and folks who know and care about and pray for Lone Rangers.
Yeah. All right, let's do it. The Lone Ranger.
Anybody seen the Lone Ranger? I heard all the stories how the man came through this town. Riding on a big white horse, this black masked stranger. Why, he met the bad guys in the street and he faced them down. And after he saved the day, he yelled, "Praise the Lord," and just rode away. The Lone Ranger.
The Lone Ranger.
Yep, the Lone Ranger.
Yeah.
Heard he had a real good friend by the name of Tonto. He didn't say much, but was right there by his side. When the big man needed help, he was right there, pronto. Together they could do most anything they tried. Now I don't know what went wrong, but the last I heard, he was riding alone, the Lone Ranger.
The Lone Ranger.
Yep, the Lone Ranger. Really, most everything I heard about the man was good. And boy, I'd give the world just to help him if I could.
Anybody like to help me go out and find a Lone Ranger?
could be this time he's the one in need. Maybe he's out there by himself in danger. And even Lone Rangers, when they're shot, they bleed. Now he was everybody's friend, so let's go out and let's bring him in. The Lone Ranger.
The Lone Ranger.
Yep, the Lone Ranger.
Yeah.
Say, Lone Ranger, can you hear me? A lot of your old friends are looking for you. We miss you. Hey, listen now. Times have changed, big fella. You can't just ride around. Nobody can, no matter how strong he is, just shooting the bad guys down and then riding off into the sunset all by himself. Why, some demon will hide back there in the bushes and shoot you right out of the saddle when you're not looking. May have happened already. Say, I got an idea. Why don't we just ride together, you know? Sort of like a posse. We can help each other. And by the way, your old friend Tonto looking for you, Kemosabe. He wants to ride with you again. And by the way, you can take that mask off now. Don't have to hide no more. Why don't you come on in here, big fella? We need you. You know something? You need us, too. Here's a Red Foley song.
Oh, well, I'm tired and so weary, but I must go along till the Lord shall come and call me away. Oh, yes. Well, the morning is so bright and the land and the night is as bright as the sea. Oh, yes. There will be peace in the valley for me someday. There will be peace in the valley.
And you can watch Pat's new show every Saturday night on Trinity Broadcasting, 9 o'clock California time. So that's what, 11 o'clock here, Saturday night. We need to put you on another daytime slot, too. Well, you're talking to the program director, so we'll see what we can
do. We'll figure it out, then.
But Pat Boone's Gospel America, thank you, Pat.
Thank you, Dan.
And you know what? We need to make a video out of Lone Ranger. Let's talk about it.
Yes, you're right.
Doesn't that make a cute video? Doesn't that make a great video? Like one of those charming videos? I love it. Thank you, Pat. One more time. Let's give him a very special thank you. We love you. What a joy to have one of the sweetest little angels in the whole wide world here with us. What can we say about Karen Wheaton, except that she's Southern, from Alabama. Come on out, Karen. Just a doll. Sings like an angel. Tell us what you've been doing, Karen.
I've been on the road.
On the road
on the weekends.
Yes.
Being a mom Monday through Friday.
Fantastic. Right here in Alabama.
Yes, about 2 hours south of Nashville.
You drove yourself up here tonight.
Believe me.
I love it. Lost all the way. Oh, well, we're ladies. What can I say?
That's right.
Well, we are glad to have you here tonight. Minister to these precious people as only you can. And you better stand up, honey. Because she's fixed to sing Hotel Hallelujah. Come on, get on your feet. Karen.
One night while I was praying, the Spirit carried me away to a land of praise and worship far beyond the Milky Way. I saw a crystal palace filled with laughter and with light. It said a Hotel Hallelujah, and we're open day and night. I walked into the lobby, welcomed by an angel host. He said, we have rooms of joy and peace in the Holy Ghost. I heard a choir singing like I've never heard before. But Lord, those high praises lifted me up off the floor. Before I knew it, my feet began to dance. I thought I'd get a bite to eat. The chef said, fruits of the Spirit are our specialty. We have manna made in heaven, bread of life freshly baked. And honey, for your entertainment, this choir's gonna serenade.
Thank you.
Is going to be one that is so special. Karen, the words in this song are so dynamite. If any of you are not feeling well right now, this talks about a promise coming down that dusty road. And when we're at our worst and feeling our worst, we always know that somewhere Jesus is waiting to come and to absolutely touch us and make us whole from depression or sickness, or sadness, or sorrow, or whatever. Every one of you could give a testimony of something you're going through tonight. Every one of you are facing a trial. Every one of us are facing a trial. But we can look down that old dusty road, and there's a promise coming down that dusty road. And if we've got it, let's roll it. Karen Wheaton singing, a promise coming down.
A hand of fear gripped the crowd that day at Jairus' home, when the doctor shook his head and said, she's gone. You could feel the mother's heartbreak, you could hear them cry and moan. The little girl was only 12 years old. But somewhere in the distance, outlined against the sun, there came a man on a mission from the throne. And they said, somebody's coming. But what they did not know, it was a promise coming down that dusty road. There's a promise coming down that dusty road.
Coming down,
and from his holy hands, healing virtue flows. He's got the key to what you need. Death and hell he will defeat. Oh, there's a promise coming down that dusty road. Wonder to mocking when Jesus did speak. He said, your daughter, she's not dead, she's just asleep. He turned to the unbelievers and he told them all, go home. They heard him say, leave me in death alone.
Coming down, the dusty road.
And from his
But let me stand here tonight and I can say I'll testify. The one thing I do know, I know he'll do it again. He's promised he would. He'll do it. He'll do it again. Give him a hand of worship.
Karen Wheaton, do we have a witness? Has he done it? Are we having church again tonight? Here in the Grand Ole Opry, coming to you from Nashville, Tennessee. Here in the heart of God's country. Amen. Well, Jan's going to bring our special new friend, Terry McMillan, back tonight. Let's tell Terry hello again. Another one of your, at least for now, hometown boys. But you know what, Terry, Jan? Do y'all want some good news? Yes. If you want the bad news, tune to them other channels. They'll give you all the bad news. We have nothing but good news on TBN. Amen. Last night, yes. Just from California, we don't have the poll from Seattle and Phoenix and Oklahoma City and Miami and New York and Cincinnati and Dayton and Oklahoma and all the other places where there are telephones, but just from California. 255 precious souls phoned in for the first time to receive Jesus as Savior. I think we ought to give the Lord a standing ovation on that. Yes! Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. And thank you, Holy Spirit, for filling this room last night and tonight with the glory of the Lord. You know, the scripture says that there is rejoicing before the angels of God for even one soul. What kind of a rally do you suppose they had in heaven last night? Mercy! They had church in heaven last night, didn't they? Do they have church in heaven? Hey, God can have church if he wants to have church. Yes, he can. Y'all sit down, and I want you to meet and say hello to a precious young man. Jan, honey, you introduce Terry McMillan.
Just such a joy. We were at the Christ Church taping the other night of that fabulous choir. TBN taped their whole concert at Opryland, and we're going to be releasing it on TBN soon. We'll let you know. And all of a sudden, the whole choir got excited. Everybody got excited, and they introduced Terry McMillan. And he came and played the harmonica. The whole choir, the whole audience, everyone shouting, rejoicing, loving this young man. And he came up to me after just bouncing. His hair just bouncing all over the place. Just I saw the joy of the Lord in his face. And he is the top harmonica player in the whole industry and played on Mike Perkey's new album, which is going to be released in January, Let's Have Church. And just after we did Mike's, he came running over one day and we were mixing Mike's album. And he said, I'm doing Johnny Cash across the street. So I went over and met Johnny. He recognized me, so I knew he'd been watching your TBN a lot and talked to me for a little while. And then we went to lunch one day with Mike and a group, and I said, Terry, just tell me your story. I saw pain, but I saw joy in this face. And to hear the story of a young man, we think we have all the excuses in the world for doing what we do.
Oh, yeah.
But this guy, if anyone had excuses, raised by alcoholic parents, drug addicts, his father in prison, his mother killed in almost killed in a car wreck, drunk on drugs, both of them dead now. And yet God chose a treasure that was in darkness, pulled it out of the darkness on a street, shined it up, and made a jewel in his kingdom. And that's Terry, and he's wonderful, and I'm so glad to meet you.
And Terry, I am sure that some of these 255, and Lord knows how many others in other parts, heard that wonderful testimony. Tell us about Granny one more time, will you?
Oh, my grandma? They call her Grandma Meter is her name. I said, call her this morning. When I first got saved, I called her and I said, I thanked her for praying for me. And she prayed for my stepfather for 53 years. Now he's like, I told you, like, you know, joined a motorcycle club.
For Jesus.
I'm sorry, yeah. But I want, one thing I wanted to tell you, you know, you was asking about me. I got to the end of my rope. I thought, I'll never be like that. I'll never do drugs or I'll never drink. And I found myself right there where they were. I was going to kill myself. I had a gun in my hand. I was going to buy my wife a house. I was going to try to buy my way out of it, you know, and just so she'd leave me alone. And I always made a vow. I said, I'll never get a divorce. I told my wife, I want a divorce. I don't care. I'm finished. I had DUIs. I wrecked 7 cars. I nearly broke my neck off of my head off my shoulders on the trampoline. Alcoholic buying a trampoline. Hello.
not real smart.
You know, but God has delivered me from that. He set me free from that. I want to tell you, and we were setting.
That's the good news we're telling you about.
Jesus. All those years of listening, I used to go to Full Gospel Businessmen's Fellowship. And you know, I'm going to tell you, I was saved and baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost, but I was still running from God. Mm-hmm. And until I learned to surrender.
Oh, come on.
And that was the key for me. When I surrendered to Him, I got to the end of the rope. I was out there. I had a little tape recorder in my hand, one of those little mini cassettes. I was talking to my wife, and I was crying. I said, honey, I love you. I said, but I can't stand it. There's too much pain in my life. I was hurting. I couldn't buy my way out anymore. I'd prayed. I couldn't quit. I'd prayed. I couldn't quit. I was doing everything, taking pills. I was, you know, smoking pot. I was drinking. Just messed up. And I saw victory in other people's lives, you know. I was going, how is this? And so then I started talking to God on this. I still got the tape, too. I started talking to the Lord.
You're making God a recording.
I was talking to Him, okay. and he welled up in me, and I put it down. I put the gun down, the 357. It was cocked. I mean, I always thought about it, but I was too chicken to do it. At this, I can see how a man can do it now, you know. I put it down. I went home, and I called a friend of mine. He came over. And we called, this was 5 years ago, and we went to a treatment center. He said, well, we can't get you in for a month. I was going, oh, a month, you know? He says, yeah. That night, a man ran away from the treatment center, and I was in the next day. Mm. And they opened me up like a can of worms. But I'm saying God led me there, because they made me realize I lied all my life. I learned from the best. I could con the con, you know. But you know what? When I learned, I said, I'm finished. I said, I'm going to tell you the truth. They said, tell everything you know. Mm-hmm. And see, a lot of those people that go into treatment centers, they don't know who Jesus is.
I know.
They just know that they need help. Mm-hmm. And the words that were here became alive here in my heart. When I learned who He was. I'm telling you, it's been 33 days I stayed in there. 33 days I was in there, and I remember I had to get up and make a speech on my last day. And I said, I'll never forget it. It was like Jesus lived 33 years on this earth. I said, and I'm coming out a new man. And when I look back, driving out of that place for the last time, because you can't go in or out. You got to stay there. I couldn't play my harmonica. I couldn't listen to music. Only thing I had to do was look at me, honestly and fearlessly. But God's word came alive inside of me. And from that point on, I've been getting better. We went to church. I want to tell you what. My home life, I used to argue all the time with my wife. It was turmoil. It was hell. I'm more in love with my wife now than ever. I can go to church now.
All right.
That's God's truth. I can go to church, and I'd be sitting in the front row. And it's like I come out of my body, not that astral projection stuff either, no. But it's like I come out, and I you know what I mean.
This is the good out of me.
That's right, the good out of me. And I look down and I see my family holding hands praying, you know. He healed my family. He's healing me. He's reconstructing me. He's renewing my mind. And he's renewing my family.
Terry, there's a lot of good old boys and girls looking in tonight, and they're just about where you were with that old 357. What would you tell them to do right now?
Look up to Jesus. Call out for help. He is there. He's more real than you know. Fall down on your knees right now. If you hear this, what I'm saying right now. He changed me. He can change you.
Good. Yes.
I ran for 33 years of my life till I got tired of running. I can't run anymore. I got tired of running. I got trying to fix it. I got tired of holding the reins and driving the car. You can't do it. You wind up licking the ditch every time.
Good Southern term.
I'm sorry. It's true. That's the way I felt, though, you know. Well, what I'll tell you what, if you'll call out to God, he will not fail you. His love never fails.
You know what? Let's agree right now that God will just give us another whole load right now.
Right now, Lord Jesus.
Join hands with somebody.
Hallelujah.
First of all, let's just ask the precious Holy Spirit. Precious Holy Spirit. Convicting Spirit of the living God. We ask you to take this testimony and these words and burn them deeply into the heart of every lost man and woman, boy and girl. Oh, Spirit of the living God, do your precious work that only you can do. Bring mighty conviction of sin. Make men and women know that they're lost without Jesus. Oh, open their hearts and their spirits and their minds now to the living God.
Yes, Lord God.
And let them cry out as the Philippian jailer of old cried out, "Oh, sirs, what must I do to be saved?" And the answer came, "Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved and thy house."
Yes. Hallelujah.
Pray this little prayer with me right now, coast to coast. Even if you're already saved, pray it out loud. It'll help someone else pray it right now. Just say, "Oh God, help me. I'm lost. I need a Savior. I do believe Jesus
is that Savior.
I believe he died on the cross, shed his precious blood to forgive all my sin. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Be my Savior now and forever. I'm yours. Amen. Amen. Oh, glory be to God. Welcome another whole busload, another whole trainload. Is that a good cue? Into the kingdom of God. Get on the phones, those of you that prayed that little prayer, meant it with all your hearts. We'll send you a Bible if you need one, and we'll ask for it, and some other literature as you start your new walk with Jesus Christ. Confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus. That's the next step right now. That means tell somebody. Just that simple. And we like for you to tell one of our prayer partners, because then they tell us, and then we tell the world, and then the world rejoices because you got saved. Shall we get on the train? Come on, all aboard. This train is bound for glory.
How many
want
to ride that train?
Yeah. I said, people, get ready. There's a train a-coming. You don't need no ticket. Lord, you just get on board.
Ain't that right?
All you need is faith, oh, and a heart full of Jesus. You don't need no ticket.
you just get on board. All aboard!
Train rolls into heaven, I wouldn't be surprised if the Lord didn't have Terry up there just playing that song as we roll into the pearly gates. Dear Lord, dear Lord, would you do my other one for me tonight? Yes. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Will you all sing it along with him as we sing? And those of you that accepted Jesus just a minute ago, come on, call.
Don't wait.
There's a prayer partner there to talk with you, love you, pray with you, agree with you in Jesus' name, and give you that first little push into the kingdom of God because of His amazing grace. How many have had that amazing grace? Wave at me. Give me an amazing grace wave tonight. McMillan. God bless you, son. Hey, you know what, Jan? Come over here a minute. Now, I know Terry has played that harp with all the greats. What? Johnny Cash, just the other day. Who all else?
Oh.
Everybody, huh?
Michael W. Smith, Ronnie Millsap, George Jones, all the gospel quartets, you know, Gold City.
But have you ever done an album?
Well, I'm in the process of, I want to do one. I'm hopefully within about 2 months I'll have one.
What do you think? Yeah. Don't you think that little mouthpiece ought to be on an album with a little singing in there too?
Just a little bit.
Yeah.
For the glory of God.
Yeah, amen.
Yeah, he's been keeping me behind the curtain. It's time to come out, man.
All right. Well, you stay tuned to TBN, okay? Because I have a feeling this young man is going to do some more blessing all of us right here on this great big old TBN network, and maybe with an album. Thank you, Terry. Let's tell Terry McMillan we really do love him tonight. Thanks for stopping by again tonight just to bless us on Praise the Lord. Thank you, Terry. Love you, brother. We'll do this again. Oh, Lord. Ain't it fun to roll the old Holy Beamer out across this land and meet wonderful new folks like all of you and Terry and then some of our old buddies from years gone by that we've loved and admired and enjoyed through the years. As I said, I don't trust a man that don't like a little country music. And, you know, back when I was an old DJ, back in the late 50s, country music was a little kinder and gentler, I guess, a little sweeter than it has kind of come to be today. I mean, whatever happened to I Can't Stop Loving You? Send me the pillow that you dream of. You know, make the world go away. That was a good one, wasn't it? And some of the grand old songs. And then, of course, well, they were grand old songs. Country songs, of course. I am speaking of country songs now, not gospel country songs. But then along comes Jack Green, and some of them are sad songs, you know. I wish I could remember that old joke about if you play country music backwards, your wife comes home,
gets returned that was stolen.
The pickup starts. The what? The dog comes home, the wife comes back, the pickup truck runs, and your son's out of... I don't know, anyway, forget it. Sorry I brought it up. But some of the good old country songs are still around, and some of them, as I said earlier, have even gotten saved, would you believe? And Jack Green is one of the country legends from right here in Nashville, Tennessee. Let's give him a big old hometown rub. Hello, Jack.
Hey, Paul. Nice to see you again.
God bless you.
Thank you, brother.
You put forth some extra effort, I understand, to get here tonight as well.
Well, we had one of those times. Everything went wrong that could.
Yes. Murphy's Law.
Yeah, we had bus trouble and three times in one trip.
I see.
Yeah, and if I hadn't had, you know, I was thinking back and talking with one of our friends backstage. Praise God, I've got six Christians on the bus. Mm-hmm. And if I hadn't had those boys that understood and knew the Spirit, I would have been hung before this day is out.
Yes,
but
yes.
They jumped in there and helped us, stayed with us.
Spiritual warfare, yes.
That's right.
As well
these
as
boys are just, they're a blessing to me.
Yes. Well, I know you all remember many of the great hits that Jack had. Of course, the one I always love and try to coax out of him every time is There Goes My Everything. That was kind of one of the sad ones, but it got saved, dear friends. And in fact, your most recent album here, I see, is entitled He Is My Everything.
He is my everything. That's right. And, you know, that's the truth, because without him, you're nothing.
Amen. Amen. Tell us in a sentence or two, how did it happen for Jack Green? When did he meet Jesus?
1988. You know, 48 years old. I mean, 58 years old. Mm-hmm. I was raised in a Christian home and went to Sunday school for a while. But when I got into music business and went to the clubs, yeah. Went to left home in Maryville and went to Atlanta, Georgia, and spent 10 years in them honky tonks. And when you're around that element, it's hard to go to church every Sunday morning. And we'd have, that was the only day we had off, and that was the day we'd take the kids out, do something, you know, instead of taking them to church like I should have. But I did that for 10 years and got on the road with Ernest Tubb for another 5 years. And of course, that schedule most of the time did not allow any church in that. One more honky tonk after another. But then when we slowed down a little bit, got our own career going, and I was just thinking back a while ago when we was talking about how many times that the Lord has changed my life around to save me from problems. And things like I was on the way on a ship going to Korea. Really? Orders came down in the middle of the trip to go to Alaska. I didn't go to Korea. One night I was driving the bus for Ernest Tubb. Something woke me up out of a dead sleep and said, get up, go drive. And I went up and asked the driver, let me drive. He said, I'm okay. I just been driving 3 or 4 hours. I'm all right. I said, no, I just want to drive. Okay. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I hadn't been driving 30 minutes until I saw 4 lights coming over the hill. We didn't have interstates back in those days. It was all 2-lane highway. Yeah. We was out in New Mexico. Top of the hill, I saw these 4 lights coming across the top of the hill. And I said, that's it. So I hit the shoulder. And by the time I got off of the shoulder, there was 2 semis coming side by side across that hill. Jack. And I've seen so many times that the Lord done things and waited on me to get through with my trip.
His mercy.
And His mercy was there. Yeah. And that was the hardest thing for me to accept was His grace. You know, I want to do it myself.
Well,
you know,
we all
want to do it ourselves. And I said, you know, surely He can't have a guy like me that's been in the music business and honky tonks and all that, the way I've lived and went through a divorce, lost all my kids and lost the house and the big fine mansion and everything, and lost everything I owned, except and including my own self-dignity. Mm. And as low as I got, He still waited. And He kept waiting and kept waiting until 1988, when I guess I had started my way back. I met a wonderful person by the name of June Standridge, and we started building our lives back together. And then in 1988, my old buddy Johnny Russell said, come out here, you got to go to this church with us. So I said, well, I'm not much of a church goer, and he kept calling and kept calling. And so we got to going to church together, and some of those people are here tonight. I see Sam and Dodie and a bunch of them are here tonight. And my wife went down about 3 weeks after we went out there. She went down and accepted the Lord as her Savior. And one Sunday morning, I was standing there, and they were singing the invitation, and the Holy Spirit just guided me down through there. I had nothing to do with it. He took me down to the altar, and I got saved in glory. Everything is so different now. It's amazing.
A new Jack Green.
Yeah,
brand new. Oh, brother, thank you for that testimony. Take up the cross. Is that what we want to sing?
Yeah, we do. That's one of the oldest we used to sing, you know, in school and church. Take up thy cross and follow me. And really, it's not really that much of a cross, is it? To me.
Compared to what the world bears.
That's right.
He said, my yoke is easy, my burden is light.
That's right.
And we've found it so, haven't
that's
we?
Right.
In Jesus' name. Of course, you will sing my song then afterwards, won't you?
You twist my arm. I will.
Come on, let's welcome Jack Green.
Thank you.
Nashville boy. God bless him.
Came down to earth, became fully a man. He did it all for my sake, according to His plan. How great was the mystery when that infant was born, conceived by the Spirit. He was God in human form. He did it for my sake and didn't count it as loss. When He took that human journey from the manger to the cross, Jesus lived as a man, so He could identify with the trials
and troubles we go through, you and I. He left heaven's glory and came to volunteer to pay the precious ransom so that God could draw us near. He did it for our sake and didn't count it as loss when he took that human journey from the manger to the cross. He went to his death in untold agony. How wonderful the wonder, he died for you and me. He left heaven's glory and he's now at God's right hand. He watches us and wants to plead the case for every man. He does it for our sake and he counts us because he has made that human journey from the manger to the cross. Yes, he took that human journey from the manger to the cross.
Love it, Jack. Hey, really now, your new album is out, He Is My Everything?
The new album is out, and also I have a video on that. I went to Grandfather Mountain over in North Carolina, right on the Tennessee-North Carolina border. Yeah. We went over there and spent a whole day. You know how videos are, don't you?
I do, yes, sir.
To get 3 minutes on video, it takes about 30 days of planning. And but we spent the whole day, and we went way up on top of Grandfather Mountain and shot some of the most beautiful scenery.
You need to get my TBN crew out there. We do them faster than that.
I'll think of that.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll.
What are?
I guess you noticed I sung the wrong song.
You did?
Yeah.
Well, I thought it was wonderful. It was wonderful. I didn't even notice.
That's in the album too.
What are some of the other songs?
Some of the other songs are, well, of course, Take Up Thy Cross and Follow Me is an old song.
Yes.
And Kneel at the Cross. I went back and got some of the old church songs we used to sing in church, and I went out to Goodlettsville to a church there and got four guys that had the greatest harmony, and they're on the album too. They just a good, you know, a good bunch of guys that gets together and sings good.
Sure.
And of course, He Is My Everything is the title of it, and there's six original songs, and one of those, that one I just done, From the Manger to the Cross, was written by the fellow that owns the record label, Step One Records, and he's an old man in Texas, but he loves to write gospel songs, and that was one of his.
All right. Okay. Well, they are what? In your bookstores and in your video?
You can just write Jack Green, Grand Ole Opry, and we'll send them to him.
Yeah. Jack Green.
Jack Green, Grand Ole Opry, Nashville, Tennessee, 214.
214.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. All right. Here comes my song, dear friends, the one that has been born again. He is my everything. I love it, Jack. Sing it. Sing it.
He is my only possession. He is my everything. I remember my days in darkness with no sunshine or light to lead my way. Then a whisper from his voice softly called me to the arms of my maker to stay. And he is my reason for the King of all kings. I long to be his possession. He is my heir. lightning and thunder. After the last bell has rung, I want to bow down before Jesus. And there hear him say,
Jack Green, God bless you, brothers. Thank you for stopping by again. We love you. God's doing some wonderful things here in Nashville, getting these good old boys saved and their songs along with them. Isn't that wonderful? Remember, drop Jack a note. Jack Green, Grand Ole Opry, Nashville, Tennessee. And Jan, get me one of those albums. I want one of those. I love that song. You know what, honey, just before I introduce Billy Walker, there is a brother here tonight that I want to just have say hello to you. He was going to be here last night with Mike Perkey, but couldn't make it. But James Payne, pastor, now evangelist, James Payne, and he's the guy that wrote, what, Let's Have Church. Hey, James. How you doing, brother?
Good here. Amen.
And what else? All those good old songs. Tick off a few of them.
Yeah, Three Old Rusty Nails, going Home Look, Walls of Jericho. Yeah. And this morning, I got to take Mike Perkey to the airport, and I would have been here last night, but we just came in from North Carolina and needed to get some rest, and I turned on the program. It was a mistake because I was up to 2:30 this morning trying to get calmed down enough to get to sleep. And so I thought I'd make it tonight. But got to hear the album this morning, Paul, on the way to the airport. And no offense to any singer, but it is the most anointed album I've ever heard in all my life. It is not a musical event. It is a spiritual experience.
Amen.
I mean, the anointing of God is on that album, and I can hardly wait. I begged him for the copy he had, and he wouldn't give it to me. So.
But now we're excited about a new one. Did y'all hear?
Yeah, I played him the song this morning.
The good news
is the bad news was wrong. I played him the song this morning. We demoed it. Played it to him on the way to the airport. And you know how Mike is. Yeah. He said, stop the van. I want to run a while. Praise God. But we're excited about that.
Well, Brother Payne, we're so glad you could at least stop by and say hello. And Lord, let's just pray.
Amen.
Give him some more of them good old songs. What do you say? And have Mike Perkey sing them?
Yeah.
God bless you. Thanks for stopping by and at least saying hello to us tonight. Evangelist James Payne. Well, another one of my old country buddies is here tonight, and I always love to see him and hear him bless me in song. You don't need any introduction. He was touring with Hank Thompson a few years ago, when many of you will remember him, appeared on Louisiana Hayride back in the 50s. Big old hits were something called Charlie's Shoes. Anybody remember old Charlie's Shoes? And funny how time slips away. Billy had 32 top 10 records between 62 and 76. Another one of your hometown Nashville boys. Come on, give him a big hometown welcome. Billy Walker. How's my buddy?
I'm all right. Fine. Thank you, sir.
You look well.
Praise God.
Any new albums and
songs? Well, yes, sir. I'm going to be singing one of the title songs. In fact, both of these songs I'm singing are out of the new album. It's, in fact, I introduced it on the show that we did from the Roy Acuff Theater the last time. Yes, it was called Let My Faith Begin to Move. It's the title song of her new album, which actually will be in the stores just right after the first of the year. Okay. I had to write a few and get another few songs to put with that one so that we could get it out.
All right, so we'll be looking forward to that, too.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
We're going to do what tonight? Going Home and what
else? Yeah, this is a little happy song. I want everybody to get happy. I know that you're happy in the spirit, and now you can get happy in the flesh. And as long as the flesh and the spirit agree, well, then it's all right to get happy, right?
Right on. Just ask the harmonica player that came.
I'll tell you what. See, we go to church together.
Do you?
Over at Christ Church, Brother Hardwick's church, mm-hmm. out here off of Nolan's. In fact, you had the choir here the other night.
Yes,
James. With Lanny Gardner and the Christ Church choir. And we go out there and we all get happy together. And I'll tell you, it's a great singing time out there.
Well, let's get happy and then we'll share a little testimony. Let's tell Brother Walker. We're glad he's here tonight.
Oh,
praise the Lord.
I love you, brother.
Hallelujah.
Well, one of these mornings won't be very long. All of God's children will be going home. I'm going home.
I'm going home.
I'm going home.
I'm going home.
We'll all be together with the Lord. Come on along. Heaven's gonna be my home. Goodbye to taxes, no more doctor bills. Forget about that mortgage, cause my banker is the Lord. I'm going home.
I'm going home.
I'm going home.
I'm going home.
We'll all be together with the Lord. Come on along. Heaven's gonna be my home. Praise the Lord. I'm going home. Come on, band, it's joyous. Just a pilgrim, only passing through. Show you my passport that says I'm gonna move.
Jesus said my children are not of this world.
I will surely come again and receive you to myself. I'm going home.
I'm going home.
I'm going home.
I'm going home.
We'll all be together with the Lord.
I'm going home.
Come on along.
I'm going home.
Heaven's gonna be my home.
Praise the Lord.
I'm going home. Okay, guitar man, it's your turn. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, now you can sing it with me. I'm going home.
I'm going home.
We'll all be together with the Lord. Hey, praise the Lord. Together with the Lord. Come on along. Heaven's gonna be my home. Praise the Lord. I'm going home.
Billy Walker. Lord, Lord, Lord. Hey. But Billy Walker couldn't always sing that song, could he?
No, I couldn't. I tell you what. I gave my heart to the Lord when I was 15 years old. I remember the day that I made the commitment, but I remember the day also at 15 that I auditioned for a talent contest. I won it. They put me on the radio, live radio back in those days, and seemed like my commitment to the Lord just kind of faded away. And it stayed faded away for many, many years. I remember the times when, you know, we would have these hit records and we had these buses and, you know, like these guys that are, we're just forerunners of the Randy Travises and, you know, the Garth Brooks and all these guys that are running up and down the highway with big buses and people following around from here to there. And, you know, you have one hit after another, and you think, you know, you're setting the world on fire, but what you're really doing, you're just setting your soul on fire. And you're burning up from the inside. And there's no Holy Ghost there to quench your thirst. And I did this for many, many years. It seemed like that the more success I had, the further away I got from the Lord. I didn't mean to get away from the Lord, but you see, I had my parents, and I had my grandparents, and I had people praying for me. And you know, that's one thing that the Scripture says, that the Lord honors these prayers. In fact, over in Revelation, it says that He puts them in a vial. That means some kind of a bowl, whatever that bowl, where it's glass or gold or whatever it is, He puts them in there. And He pours them out on the altar. Long after they're prayed, he remembers them. He puts them out on the altar. Because you see, truth never dies. You can't outlive truth. It just never dies. Truth never dies. He pours them out on the altar. And praise God. My old mom and daddy.
Thank God for them.
We're praying for Billy.
Yeah.
And all those nights we spent in the motels and all those good times we thought we were having, you go to sleep at night, or you thought you was going to sleep. You sit there, lay there and toss and turn and just wondered, what's it all for? And, but praise the Lord, I'm telling you, it's wonderful when God honors the prayers of your parents.
When were those prayers answered?
1907, the last day, the last Saturday night of July 1975, I received 17 years ago. I'm telling you, for a whole year before I really surrendered, and that's really what it's all about.
Yes, sir.
You know, our brother Terry was talking a while ago about grace and giving your heart to the Lord, but that surrendering is hard to do because you want to do it your own way, just like he said, you know, I tell you what, we'll put up a stiff fight, our will, because, you know, we think that we think sin is pretty good to us, and it is for a while, but as I said, it eats you up from the inside. And in fact, I would go to bed at night and I'd toss and turn, and I would I'd say, what's all this really for? I'm not really happy. Success don't make you happy. Money don't make you happy. And all those people's asking for your autograph. Now, I'm not saying that it's not pleasing to the flesh, but it's really not pleasing to the spirit. Only one thing can ever fulfill that deep down hunger in your heart. 1974, I had an old boy out here a couple of miles out of town, big bus company out there. And I'm having a little problem with my bus, and I pulled it out there for some guys to work on it, and this old boy came over. He said, I don't know who you are. He said, I don't really know much about country music, and I know this is a country music town. But he said, as I got here, the Lord spoke to me, and he said, you go over there and tell that long, tall fella that I got my finger on him.
Oh, right. Whoa.
You know, I really broke down and wept that day. But you see, it wasn't enough for that commitment to return. It said a whole year, and I was playing a fair up in Lincoln, Illinois, and he's got a church in a little town about 5 miles the other side called Atlanta, Illinois. Little town. I saw his buses parked out there, and I played that fair in Lincoln, so I called him up. And he came over, and we had just some real good fellowship. And then I came on my way back to Nashville, and we were playing a lot of fairs that year, 1975. I had a big record called We Meet on the Street and We Play Word Games. It was right in the top 10 about that time. And man, I was out there, you know, thought that I was setting the woods on fire. But he called me up 2 or 3 days later, and he said, Billy, the Lord has spoke to me and told me that he wanted me to spend some time with you. And I said, well, I'm playing the state fair there in Springfield at the end of the month, the last week of July, 1975, your name in lights, you know, big wheel, you know, rolling in buses and in bands down the road and doing what country music people do. But the thing about it is, As I began to play this fair, I told him that we'd get a motel room together. And I started maybe Tuesday. We were there 5 days through Saturday. And he came over on Thursday. We prayed all day Thursday. You say, well, how can you pray all day? I don't know how you can pray all day, but I know we did. Every moment that we wasn't talking and reading the Word and searching the Scriptures, we were praying. I only took out time just to go out there and play the fair that night, and then the next day we'd wake up and we'd start praying and we'd start fellowshipping about the Lord for 3 days. On that third day, there's something magical, or not magical, but holy.
Supernatural,
that's a better word.
Yeah.
About that 3 days. And I had to get up and go plug my show on Saturday morning at 7 o'clock with a radio station. But I got back to the motel, 8 o'clock. My key hit the door. He jumped up out of bed and he said, Billy, the Lord spoke to me and he said he wanted to fill you with the Holy Spirit. In reverence to God, you know, you can look prideful all you want to. You can look like a star all you want to on the stage. And you can dress up in these pretty shiny clothes. But in reverence to God, I got down on my knees with my face to the floor. And I told God, I said, God, I will give you everything I've got if you'll give me everything you have. Because I do not want to be a half-hearted Christian. I do not want to be a person that doesn't have any willpower. I want the power that it takes to keep from sinning.
And did you get it?
We started praying. This man, as we began to pray, came over and laid his hand on my forehead. And it was like 10,000 lights went right into my inner eye, my mind here. Went all through my body, came out my toes, people. I began to speak in a language I didn't even know existed. Let me tell you something, the power of God is real.
Come on.
It'll keep you. Amen. Let me tell you something. When you get filled with the Holy Ghost, And you can just bet that the devil will come up against you. Boy, he did everything in his power for the next few weeks. I went to this man's church. He said, Billy, would you come give your testimony in my church? I went over there the next morning. I watched God heal a little girl. Put a new hip socket in a little girl. I said, God, how can you do this? I had never, in the churches I'd ever been in, man, all we were commanded to do is sit there and shut up and nobody will know you're here.
Oh, Lord.
You been in some of those? Yes. Church of the what?
Of the Frigidaire.
Oh, yes. I watched God heal this little girl, put a new hip socket. That blew my mind. I made them get me the x-rays later just to prove, you know, that it is what they said, and it was. But in the meantime, I said, God, how can you do this? So he showed me about a week or so later, because I was on my way into Louisiana to play another fair in between Little Rock and Texarkana. I got a pain in my side, and by the time I got to Texarkana, I was in convulsions. And they thought everybody in the country music business was drug addicts. And so they said, well, he's okay. They thought I was on a drug withdrawal. I said, give him a shot. He'll be all right. Take him on down the road. Don't leave him here. So we went on down into Louisiana, and I woke up again. I was in convulsions again. They put me in a hospital. I had a kidney stone that had broken away and was lodged in the entrance of the tube. And to make a long story short, there was no way that this stone would pass. God began to speak to my friend and said, Billy's in trouble. You get a hold of him. So they finally found me that Wednesday night. And he said, Billy, do you believe God can heal you? And I was all shot up with pain medicine because I'd asked the doctor to wait. He wanted to operate on me. He said, you cannot get out of here. You're going to have an operation. I said, well, can you wait 24 hours? My friend called me. He said, Billy, you believe God can heal you? And I confessed that. When you're unable to have faith, let me tell you something. God provides the faith. He'll never leave you defenseless. He'll never leave you defenseless. To make a long story short, I waited 24 hours. The next morning, I woke up feeling great. I refused all the medicine, stayed another 24 hours, and the doctor said, man, something's wrong. So we go through the dye test routine, not only once, but twice that day. He come through all the x-rays on the... He said, Billy, I can't understand. Here they are, and here they're not. He said, I don't understand it. But you see, when you ask God a question, God will answer it.
Saved, baptized with the Holy Ghost,
and healed.
You got the whole load.
I got the whole load.
Billy Walker in Nashville, Tennessee tonight. Let's tell him we love him as he sings one more great song. Let my faith begin to rise.
For all you people out there that are watching tonight, I'm an encourager in the faith. That's what God has allowed me to do. Life's greatest treasure isn't silver, isn't gold, but a truth that goes beyond the grave, on which my faith lays hold, that Jesus gave his life for me. Tries to pull me under. That's when I cry out, Lord, let my faith begin to move. The mountains in my life, let my spirit. The struggles and the strife, let my faith begin to move and wonders you'll perform. Let my faith begin to move and calm the storm. To let the past close in on me, I remember what you gave up, oh, to make this change in me. Lord, don't let me fail you now. Let your faith begin to move tonight. God is a healer. Hallelujah.
God bless you. Let's tell Billy thanks for stopping by, blessing us. Can they write you in Nashville, too, if they want to?
Just Billy Walker, Grand Ole Opry. We all have mailboxes at the Opry House. 37214, I believe it is.
All right.
Lord bless you, brother. I love you. I love you in the Lord, and I love you people in the Lord tonight. God
Amen.
Bless you.
We feel that love. Thank you, Billy. God bless you, sir. Give you many, many more years of wonderful ministry. Well, our little sweetheart is back. How many of y'all been praying for Dottie Rambo that the Lord would just totally restore this little angel?
You ain't bigger in a minute. Did you know that?
About half a second, I think. I'm going to get bigger, though.
When the shoes come off, she's going to be even shorter. But, oh, how the devil has put Dottie through the mill. The shoes are coming off. That means we're getting down to business here, folks. We really are. The devil wants to kill all of you. Did you know that? He'd like to get rid of every one of you that know God, that love God, that are doing anything for God. But let me tell you something. He's a loser. He can't touch you if you're under the blood of Jesus Christ. He can't harm you. Jesus said, I'll be with you even unto the very end of the world. In patience possess your souls, not a hair of your head will perish. Dear Lord, we've read the last chapter of the book, glory to God, and we win, don't we? Amen. This thing's fixed. It's already done. We win. Hallelujah. And my little angel's getting stronger and stronger. And as I said the other night, the little sparkle's back in the eye and a little of the sass is back. I mean, Dottie is back. Bless your sweetheart. How you doing, Angel?
Well, a little croupy, but I'm feeling better tonight.
Good.
I tell you, last night, as my little Baptist grandfather preacher would say, we had a hunky-dory last night,
yes,
didn't
sir.
We?
Oh, did we not?
Yes. I loved it. I tell you, Jan, was that awesome? If we could just all live in that, we'd never have to worry about the world hating anybody. We never have to worry about abortions. We never have to worry about broken homes.
Amen.
We'd never have to worry about jealousy in ministries. We'd never have to worry about ministries crumbling if we could walk in that anointing. And when I walk into the anointing, I feel no pain. That's the reason I'm back tonight. I was all day getting here. But I love Christian television, and I love Paul and Jan Crouch. And I don't ever say anything I don't mean. You know, as long as the Lord lets me live, I say, God, hang on to the skirt tail and the coattail of Paul and Jan Crouch. Float them and move them in the spirit and give them good men like Stuart, good lawyers that know what's going on in God's business. Keep us clean in our business, Lord. Keep us stable in the business, Lord. Fill us with the spirit and give us pure words to speak for the Lord. And as long as we do that, Jan, the Lord's going to, Paul, he's going to keep us. He's going to stabilize us. Do you believe that?
I know it.
God is moving in TBN all over this world, going into Russia. Do you hear what I'm saying? Going into China. My Lord, have mercy. Did you hear that, church?
Yeah.
China! Woo! People's Republic of China! Now, can you shout happy about that?
Yes.
Sitting in Nashville, Tennessee, where all the fine music comes from, the fine records, the fine television, and sitting in these padded pews and all these lighted areas we saw around this opera land. Think about it. But think about China.
My Lord.
Some of them just caught a ear that said, Jesus. And somebody said, what is that? Jesus. And it's because one time a little radio man that ran ham radio with a little wife that looked like a little floating angel had an open ear to the Holy Spirit. Said, somewhere we can sock something up in the air that's going to contact negative and positive. Am I close to something?
Sure.
Something like that.
Close enough.
Boy, I sound like I'm smart, don't I? But God was so smart, he let Paul think about it, and God just carried it out through a willing vessel. You say, oh, but look at them. They're so pretty. They always wear such nice clothes. And so, you know, everything's just wonderful. Oh, go home and get well, folks.
Yeah, amen.
Yeah. You don't want this. You don't. Well, you wouldn't want to be in charge of all this.
No.
How would you like everybody calling you all night long? You're trying to lay there and smile and have fun with your wife.
Reading the Pentecostal evangelist.
Really? Yeah, reading the Pentecostal evangelist. That's right. Happy surprises. Go ahead and laugh. Look at somebody and laugh.
No!
I know it. Oh, I can read her mind. And it's not the Pentecostal evangelist. Isn't it good tonight? Don't you feel good? When I'm doing services, yes, he's here. That's why we're laughing. To the joy of the Lord is our strength. I wouldn't be here if I hadn't known that scripture. I'd been somewhere with my toe tagged. They're always coming in the hospital through these 9 surgeries, and they said, tag her toe. My eyes would be closed. You know, tag her toe. I said, don't you tag my toe.
I ain't dead.
It's the truth. I just lift my hands up and start talking in tongues. They say, she's gone crazy again. Get out of the way. And the devils walk in the room. Sometimes it's in forms of dogs. Sometimes it's beautiful angels. I'd always know it's Satan. I say, get out of here. Go back to hell. And the nurse says, she's cussing again.
Amen.
Not cursing, cussing. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm going to write a book about all this. It may be X-rated, but I'm going to put it out. The devil gets very nervous when my mouth gets open. Because he knows that my age and life, because I'm years old, that you got that. I'm really quite young. But he knows that C.M. Ward and I get by with anything. We got somebody who knows C.M. Ward. I love that man.
Do you know what Brother Ward says? I'll put this little parenthetic testimony here. He was on the other day as we dedicated his library. He said, Paul, I am too old to be seduced and too poor to be investigated. So I am safe.
That's my number one man. That's C.M. Ward. If you don't know him, he is a legend forever to me. He is. It's been such fun being here. Y'all through with me?
No.
Oh, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. It's making you so nervous. Really, honestly, I just must have been here last night, and I have laryngitis, so we don't care. I don't sing much better when I'm healed. But I smile a lot, covers a multitude of bad singing. During some of the services I do, I usually do about an hour right in the middle of the service. I sit down and play my guitar and just start pulling out some of the oldies. Go to ministry, like we did last night. That's what happened last night. See, the world's seen all the wonderful things, and they've seen the fakes, they've seen the gimmicks, they've watched the world go around and come back again with different kind of things happening in the ministry. But then the real folks of the world and the hurting people of the world come around to rub shoulders with those that rub shoulders with Jesus. They come into the churches where the sheep and the shepherds smell alike.
Yes.
Where they mingle together,
yes.
Where there's healing waters, where somebody will take them in their arms and hold them and love them and just say Jesus in their ear. No matter what they've done, that's the kind of Savior I serve. That's the kind of Jesus I'm looking forward to seeing. How about you? Let me sing for you a song that's kind of been one of my favorite little babies that I wrote in about 7 minutes. And they got it up there, so that's what I'm going to try to hit the notes on. Very special little baby. Let's do it for my very favorite friends, Paul and Jen. I start to say Pan and Frawl, but it's all right. That's all right. I got my feet fixed and my mouth won't work now. But go ahead and laugh. Somebody said to me the other day, a preacher said, you beat anything I've ever seen. You just have us crying in the Holy Ghost and just a spiritual, and all of a sudden you just tear loose something crazy and we go laughing. I said, you can't box God up. Amen. Can you?
No way. All right.
The sky shall unfold, preparing his entrance, and the stars shall applaud him with thunders of praise. Thank him for the voice, Lord, the sweet light in his house shall enhance those awaiting. Yes, and we shall behold Jesus in face to face. Now you say
is about ready to do it, and the sleeping shall rise from the slumbering plane. And those who remain shall be changed in one moment of time. Church, we're going to look up and we're going to see Jesus face to face. No, we shall behold. Mean it. 'Cause we're ready.
Yes. I just finished my little children's musical, and there's a little boy, Jan, you're going to eat him when you see him. He's 6 years old. And I walk out on the end of it, and I say this, Paul. They just finished Reaching Around the World, my song. And I say this. I just wrote this little thing, and it says, the family of God has always been a powerful, unbreakable chain pulling together. And every true American knows that we're stronger and bolder when we're standing shoulder to shoulder. And little Zach walks up 6 years old, dressed in his costume, blue and red stars and his American flag, and he looks up those big brown eyes and he says, and I'm ready. Are you ready? Find your place and fall in line, because we're ready. Now, we're not playing church anymore. No, we're not playing church anymore. Oh, no. You can stand or be seated. I don't care. Just as long as it's the Lord. Don't stand on your head unless it's God, though. But I'm telling you, the Lord is speaking to the remnant. To the remnant. I've been in Wigglesworth's books lately, Jan. I've been chewing them up. My land, can you imagine walking into a dead body, picking them up and slamming up against the wall and said, live! Yeah, yeah. And then it goes limp to the ground. He picks him up again and says, live! Yeah. Third time goes down. He picks his eyes, said in the name of Jesus, hit him in the stomach, and he opens his eyes. Yeah. Are you seeing anybody doing that now?
Come on.
Well, are we ready?
Yeah.
Are we ready?
Yeah.
I'm ready to see the dead raised.
Yeah.
See the lame walk. I'm ready to see you healed in the purple shirt right there. I'm ready for your back to be healed in Jesus' name. I'm ready for you, sir, for your eyes to be stronger. I'm ready for cancer back there to be. Oh, yes, in the name of Jesus, I'm ready. God's ready in that plaid right there. You, God wants you healed in the name of Jesus right now. Say, Lord, I receive it. I take it. It's mine. It's mine. It's mine. Stand up, darling, and take it in the name of Jesus. Woo! Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. You take it. Take it. Let it fall on you. Let it fall on you. Take it, take it, you take it, take it. Stand up and take it. Stand up. God's touching you right now. Just touch her, because she's the Lord. Just touch her, and she's already drunk in the Spirit right there. Right there. That's it. Just go ahead. Let the Spirit speak. That's it. That's exactly what God wanted, is the Holy Spirit speaking in tongues. That's what God wants. You with the glasses on right over there. Right, you, sir, right there. Now, stand up. Now, you stand him up. Somebody get him up. I want the Lord to reach over your head. Stand up with him. Lay your hands on the back of his head. In the name of Jesus, I speak healing. Take those glasses off. Take those glasses off. Let me see you. Let me see you in the name of Jesus. Yes, yes. Holy Jesus. Healing power of the Lord. Touch him, Lord. Let the sight come back in the name of Jesus. Yes, you're touching him. Yes, yes, you're touching him. Look, let him see clearly. Let him see clearly. Let him see clearly in the name of Jesus. Yes, yeah, look up, my brother, look up. Watch the light get brighter. Watch it get brighter. Watch it get brighter. Uh-huh. Yeah, just watch the Lord in the name of Jesus. The light's getting brighter, my brother. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, now say it, brother, say it. Do you see the light brighter? See the light brighter? Yes, I know you do. Just keep going. Just keep going. Yeah, yeah, that's it. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Shout. Over there, if you want to see a miracle, he's doing something. Yes, he is. Woo! Oh, glory! Glory! Would you like to be delivered? Would you like to have deliverance?
Would you like for Jesus to deliver you, brother? Are you tired fighting that problem? Do you want to be delivered? Do you really want to? Look at me. Do you really want to be free? Lift your hands up to the Lord. Lift your hands up. Are you tired of that load? Are you tired of it? Speak to the Lord. Speak to me. Are you tired of it? All right, the Lord's going to touch you. And I don't do this very much, but I'm going to touch your hand. It's not me going to touch you. The Holy Ghost is going to touch you. Now, in the name of Jesus, the Holy Ghost is going to touch your hand right there. And the Lord's going to set you free. In the name of Jesus, He's going to set you free. Let Him go. Let Him go. Let Him go. Devil, let Him go. Let Him go. Let Him go. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, sir. God is setting you free in the name of Jesus. Oh, yes, all the way, all the way, all the way. Look at me, sir. Look at me. Look at me, sir. Open your eyes. Look up at me. Look at me. Do you feel deliverance? You do, don't you? Say it where I can hear you. Yes. Say it again.
Yes. Yes.
Did God just do something for you?
He brought me back to the Lord.
All right. He just brought him back to Him. That's what He did. That's what He did. That's what He did for you too, wasn't it, hon? Yeah. But you, little son right here, come here and give me your hand. Y'all excuse me if we go off the air, holler at me.
Go ahead.
We're still on the air.
Yeah.
Look at me, darling. God wants to call you little David. What's your name? Mike. But you're little David. Do you know that? You have the spirit of little David, Jen. Now, you've been wanting something deeper with the Lord. You pant after the Lord. But I see so much of God in you, so much Jesus. But I see things the devil throws at you, and you're such a sensitive young man that guilt just rides your back like a monkey because you love God. Are you willing to walk like little David? Are you willing to take that cross of Jesus and follow Him? Take that gift and use it for the Lord. Will you stay clean of the world? Let God use you. Would you do that? Now, would you come a little closer to me, Michael? I'm not going to do this, but I know. What do you want the Lord to do for you?
His presence always upon me.
You've wanted that since you was a little bitty boy when you used to play church, right? Did you used to play church and preach? Yeah, I know. I saw you doing that a while ago. And the devil tried to rip you of that joy. He's a liar. He's a liar, son. And right now, you're in the ripe seasoning of your life. God's going to start using you for as many waves that lays in that beautiful head of hair. God's going to give you souls after souls after soul after soul. You'll never be the same after tonight, son. You will pay a dear price for what you'll walk through with God. You'll love it, though, son. It'll be worth it. It'll be worth it. Everybody shout praise God for Mike. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Where's Terry? Terry, where are you, angel? Come here, baby. Put my things back where I can get my guitar. Just put that back. We had something messed up, but I feel like doing this. All right with you, Jan? Okay. You know, I could do this for hours, so I'm used to it. But excuse me, sound man. I hope it didn't pop this. Terry's going to join me. Is this an awesome gift? You know, when you see the Lord take a young man like Terry, knowing some of his past, and he's not ashamed to let you know that, what the Lord has done. Well, of course, we're all ashamed of why we did it, but we aren't ashamed to tell of the miracle of how God changed us. I watch Terry and I say, God, before you take me home, let me be on stage and let me dance with a good leg while Terry plays the harp. I believe one day I will, Terry.
Amen.
I believe that. I'm in the key of D. We're just going to do something together. Are you with me there, honey? Okay. All right. We're going to just kick it like I showed you. Want to count it? Or I'll count it. I'll just do the kickoff. Okay.
I feel the touch of hands so kind and tender. They're leading me in paths that I must trod. I'll have no fear, 'cause Jesus walks beside me. And I'm sheltered in the arms of God. Sing now. So let the storms rage high, the dark clouds rise. They won't worry me, for I'm sheltered safe within. That little baby that doesn't have a home,
Somewhere there's a mom and daddy that's gonna put you in their arms and love you. You're sitting in your chair alone tonight and your companion's gone. You're still in the arms of the Lord. I've always known he was there. I was safe in his arms. If I have to walk alone, I'm not alone. I'm in his arms. We walk in covenant love, and I am sheltered in his arms. He asked me, will you marry me, Dottie? And then he took me in his arms. We had a wedding here, but soon we're gonna have a wedding there. What a day it's gonna be when I'll be forever in his arms. Oh, Jan, I wanna see you and Paul there, but I wanna see Jesus first and just lay in his arms. Now, if you don't know Jesus tonight, and you doubt every preacher that ever preached, and you don't have confidence in anybody, have confidence in the God that you're seeing right now, not me, but have confidence in the feeling that's coming over you right now. And I feel like Paul, every telephone across this country is lighting up on every TBN station. They're coming to Jesus right now. Call in, tell somebody. You're not out of reach. You're right in reach of those big arms of Jesus. Hallelujah. Just give yourself to the Lord right now. Call in and somebody will pray for you. Now just fall back, relax in Him. You are sheltered in His arms. Thank you. save you. Only that drawing and wooing of the Lord. The Holy Spirit's doing His work now, and we're just the vessels He's using. And TBN's reaching out. Listen to it now. Oh, we were once blind and lost, but now we see and we're found. Get over here, Terry. I'm in E-flat, I think. I don't really know. Well, when I'm down, when I'm down now, when my heart is filled with fear and doubt, well, when I lift up my head, just lifts up my heart, and my troubles just roll away. Roll all the way, Lord. Trouble all the way, Lord. All the way, Lord. With this track, I'll just do one more for Jan. And it's Jan's favorite, I think. And it's the one they stuck up there a while ago. We can go for something that fast or something, just what I'm going to do. For everybody, yes, the mercy throne. I feel like, Jan, there's been people, Paul, Lord gave me this song for people like that right now that He's ministering to everywhere across this nation. What an awesome thought to think that we can stand in Nashville and reach the whole world. Amen. That's what God intended when He said He would come quickly for the elect's sake. Yes. The gospel now is being sent by these great satellites all over the world. Paul said something. Paul, repeat what you said to me the other night about when I get through with the song, how it never ends. Say that one more time.
Oh, Dottie, it's an absolute scientific fact. These TV beams travel just like light beams. At the speed of light.
Listen to this.
They're not visible to our eyes, but they travel through space. This program tonight, in the first 8 minutes, it passed the sun. That's how long it takes to get to the sun, 93 million miles away. In 3 hours, this program's just about made it to Venus, one of those bright planets out there. Did you know this program will travel for eternity through space?
Isn't that awesome?
It's an absolute truth. And I always tease everybody and say, when we get to heaven in our new glorified bodies, we'll be able to whiz out past it and watch all the Praise the Lord reruns forever throughout eternity. You will see this program in heaven someday. No, that's a fact. That's just the truth.
Did you say it again? You'll see that?
It's absolutely a scientific fact. This program is out in space right now. It's traveling at the speed of light, right on past Venus, out into deep space, and it will travel forever and ever and ever and ever. This program will never end.
And just think about it. There, this man that couldn't see a thing and started seeing the lights brighter, he's going to look back and see what he was then, and he'll be whole, and he'll have his new body. Is that incredible?
It's a fact.
It's a fact. I love it. Just hit the track. I love it.
You can play along, Terry. Find it. Guilt was a voice with no promise of hope, and the walls of my prison lay claim on my soul. And listen now. Then out of my bondage, his voice spoke to me. Child, no prison can ever hold you, 'cause I have the key. Yes. Now I have gone to God's mercy throne, and I bathed in sweet waters, and my sins were atoned. God did give it to me, I still love it. Listen now. Fear has no hold. The devil hates that line. Fear has no hold. Fear has no hold. Once the fetters are gone, you're free, brother. And you see, the chains can never threaten that little eagle that's already flown. Now, you'll love this. You see, my past is all forgotten. It's a lost memory, and there is no guilt to remind me. You see, at last I am free.
Dottie, Dottie, Dottie. God bless you, darling. Jan, honey. gather everyone that is left. And we're going to agree in prayer for all of you that are calling in tonight. Dottie, we might have room for one more song. Have I sung you out?
No, Doctor.
Plumb out?
No, you haven't.
I love that song. I was the reason. For what earthly reason? I love that song very much. But some of you are still hurting tonight. Some of you are still suffering. Some of you haven't received your miracle yet. But in the closing moments of this great praise program from Nashville, Tennessee, here at the Grand Ole Opry, hey, God can move at the Grand Ole Opry just as much as He can move on Main Street or your church or anywhere else. God is here tonight. He sure did. Yes, yes. And we're going to pray and agree for your touch tonight. Those of you suffering in body yet in this room, stand up, will you? And even lift your hand. Those of you that are hurting, maybe even have physical pain, maybe that doctor's report hasn't been good, lift your hand so that we'll know where you are.
Touch them.
Would you, precious ones around these, just lay your hand on their shoulder. Just lay your hand on them right now. We're going to agree right now for the miracle of Jesus' touch in your body tonight. I want to tell you, God's doing a new work in this body. He said, they that believe shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. Lay hands on that little child at home. God's been just burning this into me to do this over and over and over again and show the body of Christ what God wants to see in you and bring forth through you to a hurting, suffering, dying world. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we reach out to suffering, hurting humanity. And in the name of Jesus, we say to you, be healed. We apply the precious stripes of Jesus, the healing blood of Jesus, to that suffering, hurting part of your body. And we agree in Jesus' name that by His stripes you were healed. And we receive it now in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Many of you in this television audience, you're feeling even now that precious touch of the Holy Spirit. For the Word of God says, if the Spirit of Him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, He shall also quicken or make alive your mortal bodies by that same Spirit. Receive it now in Jesus' name. Receive it and call a prayer partner, especially those of you that prayed to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord. We want to send you a Bible if you'll just all call and ask for it tonight. I think we could just say goodnight, Dottie, with one of the sweetest songs you've ever written. You are that reason. We are that reason. For what earthly reason did Jesus come?
He was the sacrifice.
caring to purchase our pardon. Not even the holy angels could die. Darling, the only provision for our freedom was destined to be that sweet Lamb of glory, and His only reason, church, was you and me.
Thank you, Dottie Rambo. Thank you, Karen Wheaton. Thank you, Terry McMillan. Thank you, Billy Walker. Thank you, Jack Green. Thank you, everybody. What a wonderful two nights we've had in Opryland, USA, Nashville, Tennessee. Will you pray for Jan and me as we go to Honduras and Nicaragua later this week? Your stations are on the air lifting up Jesus, and we'll bring you back a good report. Good night. God love you. We love you. And remember, let everything that hath breath from Nashville, Tennessee.
Praise the Lord. If you'd like an audio cassette of Praise the Lord, please write, ask for program 1124-92. That's 1124-92. The tapes will be sent for your love gift to the Praise the Lord program. TBN has a worldwide ministry. We need your love gifts, large or small, to help keep the gospel of Jesus Christ going around the world. So write today, Praise the Lord, P.O. Box A, Santa Ana, California, 92711. Or in Canada, write TBN, P.O. Box 24215, APO, Richmond, British Columbia, V7B, 1Y2. If you haven't asked Christ into your life, call a prayer partner now and pray to receive Jesus as Savior and Lord. Now until next time, remember to praise the Lord.
This program was brought to you by the prayers and contributions of our faithful partners throughout North America and the world.